ஆழ்வார் எம்பெருமானார் ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம், ஜீயர் திருவடிகளே சரணம். டுடே இஸ் தி மோஸ்ட் ஆஸ்பிஷியஸ் ஆனி திருமூலம் டே. திஸ் டே டிசர்வ்ஸ் கிரேட் குளோரிஃபிகேஷன் செலப்ரேஷன் ஃபார் ஸ்ரீ வைஷ்ணவாஸ். இட் இஸ் ஆன் திஸ் டே செவரல் இயர்ஸ் அகோ தி மோஸ்ட் ஒண்டர்ஃபுல் ஸ்ரீசைலேஷ தயாபாத்திரம் தனியன் வாஸ் ஃபஸ்ட் ரிசைட்டட். வாட் இஸ் தி கிரேட்னஸ் ஆஃப் திஸ் தனியன்? ஹூ இஸ் செலிப்ரேட்டட் இன் திஸ் தனியன்? ஹூ சங் திஸ் தனியன்? தீஸ் ஆர் வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ் ஃபார் அஸ் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட். தனியன் இஸ் அ இன்வோகேட்டரி வர்ஸ், a verse which is sung in praise of a particular acharya. Here the Srishailesha Dayapatram Taniyan is sung on Sri Manavala Mamunigal, Sri Varavaramani. Let us first see the Taniyan and its meanings, and then we will see the other aspects relating to this Taniyan. Sri Shailesha Daya Patram Di Bhaktyadi Gunar Navam Yatindra Pravanam Vande Ramya Jamataram Munim. This is the Taniyan. Sri Shailesha Daya Patram, that is the first part. Sri Shailesha indicates Tiruvaimuli Pillai. Sri Shailesha Tiruvaimuli Pillai is the Acharya of Manavala Mamunigal. Here in this particular section it is said that Manavala Mamunigal is the recipient of the mercy of Sri Shailesha. Tiruvaimuli Pillai was an important Sishya, disciple of Pillai Lokacharya. He was born in Kondagai, Kunti Nagar, and eventually he arrived at Alwar Tirunagari, the birthplace of Namalwar. At that time, the town itself was in full destruction. It was in ruins. He reconstructed the town. He rebuilt the temple in the town. He brought Namalwar's Vigraha, divine deity, from outside. Again consecrated Namalwar's Vigraha in the temple and ensured the temple rituals in the town happened properly. The temple had Adinada Perumal, Adinada Bhagavan, as the main Bhagavan in the shrine, and this is being Namalwar's birthplace. It was one of the most celebrated Divideshams for Sri Vaishnavas. It was Tiruvaimuli Pillai who brought this Divideshams back to life from destruction. He also constructed a new temple for Bhagavad Ramanuja, his Bhavishyadacharya Vigraham, in the western part of the town, and ensured that the temple worship happens properly there too. Such Tiruvaimuli Pillai showered his mercy upon Manavala Mamunigal. So that is the first part. Di Bhaktyadi Gunar Navam. Di is Jnanam, wisdom, knowledge. Bhakti is devotion. So Manavala Mamunigal here is praised as an ocean of such auspicious qualities like Jnanam, Bhakti, Vairagyam and so on. Yatindra Pravanam Vande. Yatindra is Bhagavad Ramanuja. Yatiraja, Yatindra, these are all names of Bhagavad Ramanuja. Yatindra Pravanam, that is one who is so devoted, so attached to Bhagavad Ramanuja. Manavala Mamunigal is known as Yati Punaravataram, that is reincarnation of Bhagavad Ramanuja. Yet he had great attachment towards Ramanuja himself. Hence he is known as Yatindra Pravanam. Just like Nammalvar Shatakopaswami is glorified as Krishna Trishna Tattvam, that is embodiment of bhakti towards Krishna, that is Nammalvar. Similarly, embodiment of bhakti towards Ramanuja is Manavala Mamunigal. That is the greatness, special greatness of Manavala Mamunigal. Finally, Vande Ramya Jamataram Munim. Ramya Jamatru Muni is the name of Manavala Mamunigal. I worship such Ramya Jamatru Muni, says the author of this Taniyan. Now, who is the author of this Taniyan? That is, Bhagavan himself is the author of this Taniyan. Now, Bhagavan, being the Prathamacharya, the first foremost Acharya of our Sampradayam, he is the knowledge giver of everyone. He is the one who grants knowledge to everyone. Why does he worship Manavala Mamunigal? Why does he consider Manavala Mamunigal as his Acharya, as his preceptor? That's a very interesting question. We will see the answer. For this to understand, let us see one example. Peyalvar in Moonram Thiruvandadi has sung a beautiful pasaram. Maganuruvar kallada mameni mayan. Maganam avan magandan kadal maganai. Here, Peyalvar says, Bhagavan, who is not a son of anyone, becomes a son of Vasudeva, Nandagopa, and then he has his son, Pradyumna, and then Pradyumna has his son, Aniruddha. Such Aniruddha got into trouble and Bhagavan rescued him, Krishna rescued him. That is the meaning of the pasaram. But here the main thing to understand, main aspect here is, Maganuruvar kallada mameni mayan. Bhagavan, who is not the son of anyone, he is unborn. He is never born as a son of anyone originally. He always existed, and in fact, he is the Jagatpita. He is the father of everyone. But such Bhagavan chooses one of his creation, one of the persons he has created, he chooses such person as his father and he takes birth. For example, it is well known that Bhagavan was born as Sri Rama, as the son of Chakravarti Dasharatha, and he served him, he obeyed him sincerely. Similarly, he was born as the son of Vasudeva and he considered Nandagopa as his own father and he obeyed them, he served them. Why did he do that? Nambillai Lokacharya in his commentary beautifully explains this principle in a very detailed manner in this pasaram. He says, one will desire for something one does not have. As Bhagavan does not have a father, he craves for one and he becomes a son, a child of one of his own creation, and then he shows love towards that person and considers him as his father. So we can see this, Bhagavan being the Jagatpita, and yet he takes someone else as his father. Similarly, Bhagavan is the Acharya for everyone, but he too craves to have an Acharya. He too likes to have a teacher. And he did have some teachers previously. As Sri Rama, he had Vasishta as his teacher. He had Vishwamitra as his teacher. As Krishna, he had Chandipani Muni as his teacher. But he was not satisfied with them. He was seeking for a real Acharya. Acharya means one who learns Shastram, one who teaches Shastram to others, one who also practices it fully. So he seeks an Acharya who is perfect in the qualities of being a teacher, being an Acharya. And he found Manavala Mamunigal as that most deserving, most qualified Acharya. That is why Bhagavan himself accepted Manavala Mavnigal as his Acharya and submitted this Taniyan, this Shlokam in praise of Manavala Mavnigal. So when did that happen? It was in Sri Rangam. Bhagavan, Sri Ranganatha, Periya Perumal, is enjoying wonderful services from many Sri Vaishnavas in Sri Rangam. He is enjoying the beautiful serene atmosphere. And Manavala Mamnigal is present, Varavaramuni Swami is present at that time in Sri Rangam, bringing our sampradayam to great heights, teaching the pasurams of Alvars, Sri Vaishnava Siddhantam, Vishishtadvaita Siddhantam and so on. Periya Perumal, Sri Ranganatha, considers once to glorify Manavala Mamnigal and bring more greatness to Manavala Mamnigal. On the concluding day of a Pavitrotsavam in 1 year, Periya Perumal, Sri Ranganatha, orders Manavala Mamnigal to come in front of him. When Manavala Mamnigal goes and stands humbly in front of Bhagavan, Bhagavan orders Manavala Mamnigal to explain the meanings of Thiruvaimuri with Nambillai's Eedu Maha Vyakhyanam, the great commentary of Eedu for Thiruvaimuri Sahasra Gita, with all supporting Granthams, Shastram and all of that. Manavala Mamnigal becomes humbled. He says, if that is the order of your highness, I will execute it. And Sri Ranganatha, along with his Nachiyars, divine consorts, Alvars, Acharyas, all of them are present in the great assembly and starts listening to Manavala Mamnigal's commentary, Kalakshepam of Thiruvaimuri with Eedu Vyakhyanam. This goes on for a whole year. Manavala Mamnigal explains Thiruvaimuri with citations from Vedam, Vedantam, Itihasas, Puranas, Sri Pancharatra Agama, Smritis, other pasurams from Divya Prabandhams. With all of these, he explains the wonderful meanings of Thiruvaimuri. Everyone in Sri Rangam joyfully listens to Manavala Mamnigal's commentary, Manavala Mamnigal's explanations for a whole year. On the day of conclusion, Periya Perumal has a great plan. He devises a great plan to honor Manavala Mamnigal at that time. Once the Satumurai was done, once the Kalakshepam was concluded, the lecture session was concluded, Bhagavan Sri Ranganatha appears through the form of a small child of an archaka and he starts reciting Sri Shailesha Daya Patram. The child stops with that. Everyone becomes amazed. There is this small child who doesn't even speak properly, now starts reciting a beautiful Sanskrita shlokam. They all encourage the child, go on, recite more. And the child says, Di Bhaktyadi Gunarnavam, Yatindra Pravanam Mande, Ramya Jamataram Munim. Reciting this, he runs to the back of the crowd. Everyone becomes amazed. They quickly note down the shlokam and they bring the child again in front of the crowd and ask the child to recite the shlokam one more time. But the child is unable to recite now. He is speaking in his childish, blabbering way. So everyone understands that this is the divine order of Bhagavan himself. So they go and place that palm leaf where the shlokam was noted down at the lotus feet of Bhagavan, get it blessed, and at that time Bhagavan gives an order saying this Taniyan should be recited at the beginning of every Divya Prabandham or Stotra Patam recitation. It is said at that time that the pasurams which are recited at the end of Divya Prabandham recitation, Vali Thiruvai Mulipillai Madhagaval, that pasuram, Seyyathamarai Thalinai Vaaliye, Adiyargal Vaala, Aranganagar Vaala, all of these are in glorification of Manavala Mamunigal. It is said that even these were revealed at that time. Bhagavan ensures that this Thaniyan is recited in the beginning and at the end of all Divya Prabandham recitations. At the same time, just as it happened here in Srirangam, Thiruvengadamudayan in Tirupati, Tirumala, Thirumalirinjole Azhagar, Kalladagar, Bhagavan, they too ordered that this Thaniyan is recited as part of Divya Prabandham in the beginning and in the end. So all the Sri Vaishnavas become very joyful. They greatly celebrate this Thaniyan being spoken by Bhagavan himself. Not only this Thaniyan, Bhagavan gave great honor to Manavala Mamunigal. We have seen that Manavala Mamunigal is the incarnation of Bhagavad Ramanuja. We all know that Bhagavad Ramanuja is incarnation of Adishesha. Manavala Mamunigal, Varavara Muni Swami, is also incarnation of Adishesha. But we only observe that Manavala Mamunigal has Adishesha Simhasana, Pariyanka. That is because Bhagavan himself offered his Shesha Pariyanka, his Adishesha Pariyanka, to Manavala Mamunigal as a gift to the Acharya, as a present to the Acharya. It is said that a disciple should do at least two important things to his Acharya. First, the Shishya, disciple, should have the name of the Acharya as his own name. We can see that Sri Ranganatha, Bhagavan, has Ramyaja Matru, Adigya Manavadan, as one of his names. Manavala Mamunigal also carries the same name, Adigya Manavala Mamuni, Ramyaja Matru Muni. So, Bhagavan naturally arranged that he has the same name as his Acharya. It is also said that a disciple should offer his most expensive, valuable possessions to his Acharya. Bhagavan offers his Shesha Pariyanka, which identifies his supremacy. Whoever is resting on Adishesha is known as the Supreme. So he gives his own Adishesha Pariyanka to Manavala Mamunigal as a present. It is also said that disciple should write shlokams in praise of Acharya and celebrate and make sure that his Acharya is praised all over the world. Bhagavan also ensured that he recited Sri Shailesha Dayapatram Thaniyan. He ensured that this is recited all the time by Sri Vaishnavas and brought great glories to Manavala Mamunigal. There are so many Thaniyans in our Sampradaya. Many Alvars have Thaniyans, Acharyas have Thaniyans. But still, this Sri Shailesha Dayapatram has a special place. Such is the greatness of Manavala Mamunigal. Bhagavan's attachment towards Manavala Mamunigal is very significant. And on this particular auspicious day of Ani Thirumoolam, we enjoyed this incident, this advent of Sri Shailesha Thaniyan a little bit. Alvar Emperumanar, G.R. Thiruvadigadesharanam, G.R. Thiruvadigadesharanam.
To learn such valuable information about our Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya, please download Koyil, K-O-Y-I-L app from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Our website is koyil.org, K-O-Y-I-L.org.